Danielle Bourjeaurd. How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Good. Did I get your last name right?
You nailed it.
All right. Awesome meeting you. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, well, I'm from Ontario. Sharon, Ontario girl, grew up there. I moved to Nashville. I've been there for 5 years now, writing and performing and doing, you know, writer's rounds. And we've just been working really hard on this record for the past few years, I would say. And we finally found the 7 songs that did it for us as a great entrance into the Canadian country world. And it's called Country Sort of Way. It'll be out in September.
Right on.
And so right now we're on the Lakeside single tour across Canada. Literally driving across Canada. Thanks, Mom.
It's been a long leg for you, though, right? You've been to many stations. And,
oh, yeah.
Are you new to this kind of a thing?
No, I've actually... I did a radio tour in the States.
Okay.
So I did... It was like more of a writer's kind of tour, and I just got to know a lot about, you know, how it all works, and it's great. I mean, it's a positive reaction, which is nice, and it's always welcoming, and I'm really happy and excited to be doing that in Canada right now.
The new song is called Lakeside. I had a chance to listen to that song this week, and I love this song. It's a good tune.
Thank you, man. That makes me super happy.
Let's talk about, and you're going to perform it shortly here, but let's talk about what went into Lakeside.
Well, I wrote that song with my buddy Stone and another Canadian, Ian Janes, and we kind of were just writing a fun song. It was beautiful, sunny day, missing home, missing Ontario, Georgian Bay, and so we started writing this song, and it was just kind of the feel-good, relaxed vibe, organic guitars, you know, with the new kind of drum loops, and we wrote it for the catalog, and then... The more I heard it, the more I fell in love with it. And I didn't actually believe it was going to be a single. We thought Country Sort of Way was going to be the first single. But we thought, you know, with the summer and everything coming out, yeah, why not release that? So I hope everyone likes it. I mean, it makes me, when I heard it back the first time, I thought, you know, this is perfect. You just want to kind of chill out on the water, have a cold drink in your hand. Not much any other Canadian would want.
That
for
sounds
the summer,
good to me.
Right?
We were just talking off air about a few Nashville stories that you had. One thing that I love to hear, can we talk about your dog?
Sure, cool. Yeah, Brooklyn.
Such a cool story about your puppy. Tell us how you got her.
Well, I was nannying for Tanya Tucker, and she was on tour, and I had her for a little while, here and there, all the time, for her daughter, Presley. And I finally gave her back after the summer was ending, and a call around a few months later, it was like, Brooklyn is not eating, and she's very lonely, and she misses you, and we couldn't figure it out, but we figured it out now. So when I went over to the house, she was just literally like crying with happiness, and I thought about it. I was like, you know what, how can I not take this beautiful little big-eyed chihuahua? So she really is a sweet dog. She doesn't make a peep on the road. I take her everywhere with me. Aww. And she gets along great with her little sister, her little big sister, I should say. I have a Staffordshire Terrier pit bull, so Kanga and Brooklyn they love each other. It's a funny kind of love. It's like when I leave, I come back home and I see them cuddling on the couch, and then they're like, oh no, this didn't happen, you know, don't look, Mom. But Kanga loves Brooklyn, and Brooklyn's the boss.
You were talking about being a nanny for Tanya Tucker. What was the transition? How did you become a nanny and then go to becoming a country music singer?
Her daughter, actually, Presley, was singing the high harmonies in a band that I put together for a little bit, and we just kind of became great friends, and I met Tanya one night. We were in Midtown, and I don't know if I should say this, but yeah, Presley had a couple too many wobblies. So she's like, oh, let's just go back to my mom's house. It's right here across the street. So I was like, okay. So we walked and knocked on the door, and sure enough, she was super sweet. Tanya was great. She said, come sleep in my guest room. And she was laying there with 8 other dogs in her apartment. And yeah, I just, you know, it's so funny because Nashville's such a little community with so many, you know, stars. But the thing I love about it is, like, nobody's really starstruck. Everybody just kind of walks in. You see them at the bar. They're sitting down. It's just normal life, and especially Midtown area. It's a lot of the local people. So it's a cool vibe down there.
We got Danielle Bourjeaurd joining CFWE. Her brand new single, Lakeside, is out right now. Love to hear a live version of Lakeside.
I would love to. I'm just going to stand up here and play you guys Lakeside.
Again, it's Danielle Bourjeaurd live at CFWE.
Sipping on mojitos, swatting at mosquitoes, mind on my own, got my drink and my copper tone. Yeah. And every time the sun's out, boys got them guns out, girls got a little sundress or a little less on. You know it's on. Skinny dip, a chunky dunk, whatever you got in the trunk, rocking every day and night on the lakeside, living it up. Three or more, tequila, margarita, salty lime, and all my good time and friends. The party never ends. No, it don't. Yeah, your lips on my lips. No 5 o'clock whistle and there ain't no closing time. Your tent on mine. Chilling out, grilling out, summertime is all about. Day and night on the lakeside, living it up, living it up, living it up on the lakeside, living it up, living it up, I'm living it up on the lakeside. So get that fire burning, tune up them guitars. I think I'll just stay here and drink underneath them stars, and we'll be living it up, living it up. I'm living it up on the lakeside, living it up, living it up. I'm living it up on the lakeside, living it up, living it up. I'm living it up on the lakeside, living it up, living it up. I'm living it up. Got my drink in my copper tone, yeah.
All right, that was awesome. Danielle Bourjeaurd live at CFWE. Known as the Redneck Princess, what's that all about?
Well, I guess I'm just, I've got a girly side and I've got a country side, and together I've been named a lot of nicknames kind of around that hashtag Redneck Princess. I'll tell you one story. Well, we had Gil Grand help me, him and his wife, they helped me move into the Gulch when I went to Nashville. And I didn't realize at the time, but the Gulch was this very nice side of town. So I pull up in my U-Haul, and my mom's like, okay, this is going to be interesting. So we open up the trailer, and sure enough, you know, we've got the movers moving all the stuff in there. So we've got our moose antlers, our cowhide rugs, our deer heads, our moose Bass Pro curtains from you know, the bathroom to the bedroom. So it was very, it looked like basically Bass Pro had thrown up all over my apartment, and I loved it. And I mean, all my friends there, they always thought, let's write in your room today, because it was like a trip to the cabin or a trip to, they said this is so Canadian or Alaskan, but I mean, I loved it, and, I own the name, and I was like, yep. Sure, I'm a redneck princess. Whatever you guys want. And you just said you Googled me, and the very first thing you read was Redneck Princess.
That's right.
So I guess that's it now. That's my name.
You're going to be at the CCMAs in September. That must be a cool thing for you too, eh?
It's super cool. I'm so happy and honored to be one of the CCMA Discovery finalists. And I'm in it to win it. So please come out on Thursday. I'm going to put on one heck of a show.
Right on.
And I'm up against 5 other amazing, talented artists that you're going to not want to miss. And it's going to be a lot of fun. You know, and you're going to come.
That's right.
And
we're
going to have a beer in the beer tent.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Maybe a coffee. Don't say that on the air.
Oh, yeah. Coffee.
Hey, Danielle, awesome meeting you. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you so much.